So I just had one of the most incredible experiences with a travel credit card, and it saved me $1,931 on a flight to Japan. But what's crazy is that's not the only benefit that I'm receiving from this card. So in this video, I'll share my honest experience using the Chase Sapphire Preferred Card, including all the additional benefits that I love about it, the annual fee, and if it's really worth it, and the sign-up bonus, which has gotten even better lately, and I'm actually jealous of it. Plus, I'm gonna share the ebook that helped me learn how to use points this way, because I probably never would have figured out this travel hack on my own. Well, hey there, world travelers. I'm Kendra Lucas of Lucas World Travel, and along with my husband, David, we've been traveling the world full-time for 4 years now, sharing with you all the tips that we learn along the way. So if you could use a little bit more travel-saving tips in your life, then be sure to subscribe for more. Now, one qualifier that I have to make about using credit cards is that you have to make sure that you pay off your entire balance in full every month for these benefits to be worth it. Because if you're paying 20% to 24% interest, this will cause you to lose the majority of your gains. But as long as you're paying your bill in full every month, the benefits of this travel credit card far outweigh the risk. So I signed up for this Chase Sapphire Preferred Card in December for my upcoming trip through the Caribbean. Now, the main benefit that I was most looking forward to was the auto rental collision damage waiver, which reimburses you up to the actual cash value of the rental car for both collision damage and for theft. Now, considering I've paid an exorbitant amount of money for car rental insurance over the years, I really looked forward to declining car rental insurance from now on and just enjoying being automatically covered by paying with my credit card. So for me personally, this benefit alone has saved me hundreds. Another benefit that I enjoy is that this card has trip cancellation insurance. So it reimburses you for non-refundable travel expenses canceled either due to sickness or severe weather or some other reasons as well. Again, this is another insurance I can happily decline now and just use my credit card instead. In addition, I really like how on their website they have a spending visualizer that helps me see at a glance exactly how much I'm spending in each category. So when I had a month that I spent $800 on restaurants, it really made me check myself and like, do you really want to spend your money that way? And then the very next month, I was able to get my restaurant spending down to $400 a month, which is much more reasonable while you travel. So this feature has saved me budgeting-wise, big time. Like most travel cards, though, the Chase Sapphire Preferred Card does not have any foreign transaction fees, which also saves you money with every purchase you make abroad. But naturally, the biggest benefit is the points you earn and that you can transfer those points to select airlines and hotels. Now, when I first signed up, I didn't know just how valuable these points would be. So let me tell you how these points saved me $1,900. So when I got my point sign-up bonus and was shopping for travel on the Chase portal, I wasn't really finding any travel deals worth spending my points on. I'm on the island of Martinique now, and after spending 5 months island hopping in the Caribbean, we were looking forward to a change of pace. We've always wanted to go to Japan, but naturally, plane tickets from the Caribbean to Tokyo can be very expensive, with one-way tickets starting at $1,195. Luckily, I looked at how many points it would take to get to Tokyo because the amount of points needed was much less than the amount of cash needed. We're talking only 40,000 to 44,000 points on some days versus a whopping 160,000 points on high traffic days. So this point price seemed a bit too good to be true. So I only transferred enough points to pay for one ticket because I was hesitant, like, is this actually gonna work? And once you transfer these points, they're transferred forever. You can't transfer them back. So I wanted to be sure that I was doing the right thing. So I transferred the points and I got my flight for 44,000 points plus $212 in cash for those airport taxes and et cetera. Once I saw it worked, and by the time the points I transferred for David's tickets, which does take about 1 to 2 days, so by the time I spent the days to transfer the point price was a bit higher than before. So for his ticket, I wound up paying 39,000 points plus $350, which I was still very pleased with. Now, if we had paid cash for these tickets, plus having that one check bag, we would have paid $1,249 per person. So a total of $2,498 total. But with this credit card points transfer, we only spent a total of $566 for two people to fly to Japan one way, which I think is a real steal. Now you might be wondering, how did I learn to do all of this? And honestly, I didn't learn on my own. I got this ebook called the JGOOT Way of Travel, which stands for the Just Get Out of Town method. This short ebook was really informative, to the point, and it helped me to finally understand the best credit cards to use and the most effective strategies to maximize your points. So I've included a link to the ebook in the description box below. The ebook has many more strategies that I haven't even tried yet, but I highly recommend it because it saved me nearly $2,000 in just one transaction. And also the credit card itself. Considering all of its benefits, I would say the annual fee of $95 is well worth it. This card is saving me money on car insurance, trip cancellation insurance, and getting me cheap flights to Asia. I have definitely received more than $95 worth of value, and I will definitely be renewing this card for another year. Now, when I signed up for this card, the sign-up bonus was only 60,000 points. But for a limited time, if you sign up now, you can get 75,000 points. So I've included my referral link below so that you can take advantage of this deal while it lasts, because 15,000 extra points can really lead to a lot of extra travel savings. Now, at first, I was so hesitant to get a card with an annual fee because it didn't make sense to me. Why would I spend money to use a credit card? But now, I really do get it. You get so many benefits, from the included insurance to all the points, that can be worth thousands. And that makes all the difference in the world. But what about you? Do you have a favorite travel credit card? If so, let me know in the comments below, because I'm always on the lookout for a new travel card. Also, don't forget to subscribe for more travel tips and destination guides from all around the world. Until next time, check out our 10 ways to afford full-time travel on the right there. As always, thanks so much for watching. Thanks for sharing with all of your travel pals, and happy travel planning. Until next time.